Use HDMI when possible. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is a very simple thing that I've discovered a lot of people overlook, especially as they upgrade their equipment over time. So there are multiple different kinds of connections between your computer and your external display. In the past, the more common connector was a VGA or video graphics array connector. Here's a picture of one end of a VGA cable, and here's a picture of the socket that you might be plugging it into in your computer or your computer's graphics card or whatever. VGA is actually quite old. It goes back, gosh, maybe 20, 30 years by now, if not longer. The issue with VGA is that it is an analog signal. And it's an analog signal that wasn't really designed for the high resolutions we tend to have today. What that means is that when you connect it up to your modern computer with your modern display, your flat panel digital display, it'll work. Most flat panels, most displays still have a VGA connector for compatibility, but the picture will be fuzzier than it needs to be. It just won't be as sharp, and it won't have the highest possible resolution that your display is able to provide. Now, a lot of people, the reason that I mention this at all, is what I'm seeing is that a lot of people have an older computer. They replace the computer, and they just plug in the cable to the existing monitor. They replace the monitor, and they just plug in the cable to the existing monitor. In other words, they never change the cable. It's probably the only thing that stays constant. So they end up with a machine that's capable of better, using a monitor that's capable of better, and yet they're stuck with the VGA interface. The interface that I strongly recommend you use instead, if both ends are capable, is HDMI. Now, there are other digital interfaces, don't get me wrong, but they seem to be falling out of favor. They seem to be slowly going out of the way in favor of HDMI. HDMI, which stands for High Definition Multimedia Interface, is a digital interface that is designed specifically for the kinds of displays and the kinds of computers we're using today. Like I said, there are some other digital interfaces, but I'm not going to talk about those because, like I said, they're kind of sort of fading away into obscurity. HDMI you may already be familiar with because it's probably what you might be using to connect up your cable box to your television set. That's where HDMI originated. Here's one end of an HDMI cable. You recognize the shape of that connector. Here's an HDMI socket that you might find on the back of your computer, the back of a monitor, whatever. This is what I want you to use instead. The reason that HDMI is so much better than VGA is twofold. One is it's more than a connector. It's a protocol. The monitor and your computer actually kind of talk to each other. And the monitor will let the computer know, here's what I'm capable of. Here's my maximum resolution. Here's my preferred resolution. And the computer, if the video card is capable, will start using that resolution automatically. You can change it, of course, in the user interface, but you probably don't want to. You want to use the resolution that your display handles natively. HDMI just makes that possible. It tells the computer what your monitor is capable of. The other, and this is something a lot of people don't realize, is that think about how you're connecting up your cable box in your TV. You're not adding any sound card, any sound cables. It's because HDMI includes sound. It includes good quality sound. That way, if you're using HDMI to connect your computer to your display, and your display happens to have speakers in it, you can get your sound out of those speakers instead of needing more cables, more speakers, more equipment. So HDMI is going to give you a better quality picture because it's higher resolution and it's designed specifically for digital displays that we're all using these days. In addition, you may be able to get sound out of your display if your display supports it. The bottom line for you is this. Check the connection between your computer and your display. If it's a VGA connection and both your computer and your display are capable of HDMI, and you'll know that because they'll both have an HDMI socket of some sort, switch. Get yourself an HDMI cable, plug it in, unplug the VGA cable. Your computer should just recognize the difference, and you should be looking at a much, much better display. For updates, for comments, for related links, and more, visit askleo.com/148233. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.